My brain flicks back into focus. Off the train, through the tunnel, outside where my feet touch the ground and I'm grounded. Other places may feel like home, but none hold the keys that unlock my memories. So as I open the gate and I hear it creak, eyes focus forward on a blue door inside a glass porch with carpet in it. Not quite ready to return with a face that's seen the worst in me, I sit on a step that's been painted over 5 times throughout my lifetime. And as I count the chips in the concrete, I remember times I've sat here before. My mind moves with a mind of its own, my eyes close, and soon all my well thought out reasons become fleeting excuses. This step that's 2 steps away from what I can't bear is just enough for me. It's a few steps away from air that stick with words that can't be taken back, and I've not got the greatest memory. So things I thought you said become things I know you said. But this step has enough emptiness to fill me. So I sit, breathing in a new way of thinking, hoping to become forgetful. And as I breathe, my eyes are opening. My ears are hearing and my skin is feeling. Worlds apart from the inside of that house that I thought was mine, but now I look at it with older eyes, I see. This house and this door, they don't belong to me. When I was smaller, I knew my house. I knew the inside and the out. I remember when we were taller, our brains bigger and our minds full of quick slap remarks, Mum started letting us out, me and my sister. She built a new part of the house, a pre-house, so that when we came back, there was a middle ground between the inside and the out. A space not quite home, but still protected under lock and key, a place where those keys could be found with the promise of security. And real near, her wide awake, bed-bound body. But with the creak of a door and the final close, and the low rumble of a dog who knows his home, she would let her mind rest and sleep. She felt that though she could not keep us by her side, she could build walls for us to feel safe in. She'd say, in here, we're safe from everything. She'd say, when I was younger, we'd have open doors. But now she keeps the world shut out. And who lives here now? From this step, I can see into other people's worlds through uncovered curtainless windows, watch their TVs over their weed-filled front gardens, staring at my childhood home. Lead-lined windows and stone on stone, I can see the past. Yet I can't see past the irreverent net curtains, firmly on the outside now. I look at my second floor bedroom windows. I remember secret cigarettes climbing out of those windows onto the rooftops. I remember the installation of window locks. And I stare at it now. And I wonder why I never saw the cracks in the walls before. Why I never noticed the broken doorbell. Why I always thought the inside was so much safer than the out when it's not. Walls that I now see just provide the illusion of protection and security. I sit and I balance between the present and the past.